a little mini workout for you today. I'm going to call it the summer travel workout. So I always just feel like summer gets busy and we're pretty active and we're doing lots of stuff. We end up traveling a lot, whether that's just car trips, whether you're taking a vacation, whatever that is. And sometimes I feel like you just need to kind of move your body. You know, we sit in the car for a long time or an airplane and you just get tight and your body kind of just craves some movement, some of that good Pilates movement that we do in all different directions with our spine and our body. And so this little sequence is designed to just be a short little sequence that you can do anywhere to really just get you feeling better. We're going to add that Pilates breath in and core work and just get your body moving. So we're going to use a TheraBand. I love the TheraBand from a travel standpoint because you can take it anywhere. You can like stuff it in your suitcase. It fits like in your shoe or something. You can have it in the car. It's such a great little piece to take with you. So we're going to start with that. All right, Shelly, you ready?
Yeah.
We are going to start with just some roll down. So Shelly's just going to put the band around her feet. And I'm going to have her start with bent legs and then maybe go to straight legs. You can always choke up a little more, a little less. And with her breath, she's just going to start rolling her spine back. Inhaling for about half, exhaling for that second half to roll down. And then she gets to curl back up. And just getting that rolling and moving through our spine. Full breath in each direction. Good. And the more you bend your knees, you might find that helps you curl a little bit more. So sometimes I like to start with bent legs and then kind of work my way to straight legs on there. Good. And just going to feel good. So you can stretch the arms. Sometimes it feels good to stretch the arms out. Just really let yourself get this spine stretch. And then as you roll back, you kind of feel like you're ducking under a low ceiling. And just thinking that, like everyone, you get a little more movement in your back, a little more articulation. And of course, we're really moving from our center and feeling our abdominals pull up and in. That's what's going to give your back that stretch. If that band is nice and supportive, which is one of the things I love about it, because it really allows you to get more movement in your back, gives you a little support, and then you can really curl and stretch so it feels good. And then let's just roll back to the mat one more time. And I'm going to have Shelly stay there, and she's just going to take her left foot out of the band, leave the right one in there. We're going to just do some stretches here. She's just going to bring the leg up. We're just going to start with a hamstring stretch. She is just using the band to get a nice stretch through the backs of the legs or back of the leg. And she can just hold it. You can kind of play with it. There's not like an exact right or wrong on here. When we sit a lot, right, those hamstrings get tight, our low back gets tight. And so just like gently pulling that leg back towards you until you feel a gentle stretch in the back of the leg is just going to feel really good. If you wanted to add a little variety and even to like do a little movement with your foot and ankle, you could do a little point and flex. Sometimes that's kind of nice. Get our feet moving a little bit. And just that nice Pilates breath as you're there. You know, if you've got a little time, this is just a great place to hang out, breathe, stretch a little bit. And then we're going to take a few variations on this. I'm going to have Shelly take both straps into her right hand. And then I'm going to move out of the way, and she's going to stretch the arm out to the side. And should I just reach that left arm out to the side? That can feel good and kind of help you counterbalance a little bit on the stretch. And really just finding that stretch in your inner thigh, probably also a little bit in those hamstrings, backs of the legs. And again, just a place to kind of take some stretches. Still good core work if you're thinking about engaging those core muscles and just kind of anchoring to your mat a little bit. Just add a little point and flex. Good. Let yourself play around a little bit. Just getting moving. And then we're going to take a big inhale as you exhale. So just pulling the abdominals in as you bring the leg across your body. And then she's going to play with pulling it across. And you can pull it across as much as you like. Right? You can let this hip lift. I like to really just keep that shoulder anchored. That gives you a twist through that low back. You're going to get this whole outer thigh stretch through the leg. You can play with flexing and pointing the feet. And just that nice deep breath as we're there. Okay, this is just going to feel good on your body. Nice. And then we're going to take a nice big breath. And of course, if you're doing this at home or following along, take as long as you want on those stretches. And then let's just switch and do that on the other leg. just going to stretch them both out. And Shelly's got this leg straight. If your hamstrings are really tight, you might need to bend that leg. Whatever feels best for you. We're going to let her stretch it out. And again, just that gentle pull back to what feels like a good stretch for you. And then, you know, you can hold it in one spot and just be there. You can do a little movement back and forth. Good. As you're holding it, maybe just thinking like your heel is stretching up for the ceiling, and at the same time, your left hip is just sinking down. So we're just creating that length in that whole back of the leg. And again, like foot movement's fine on there. Good for those feet to get a little flexibility and strength. We'll go ahead and take the leg out to the side next. So both straps into the left hand as you take it out there. Reaching that right arm to the side is gonna help you anchor a little bit. I like to really like anchor down this heel and anchor this hip, which feels like a little bonus work on there. I have to like keep your right rib cage anchored. Yeah. And then we're just gonna take another breath there and think about that core engagement as you bring the leg up and across, and then Shelly's just gonna play with that, reaching the leg across. And again, you can kind of play with it a little bit and come straight across. You might pull it towards you a little more, or you might let it reach down towards your foot more. It's going to change that stretch a little bit, just getting a little bit of that movement, that length. And shoulders nice and heavy. Good. And then we're going to take a big breath. And again, if you're doing this at home, like take your time on those stretches. Hang out for a little bit. All right, I'm gonna have Shelly switch back to the other leg, and we're gonna head into our single leg circle exercise. And I love this exercise with your TheraBand. And when we're thinking of it from kind of stretch range, so number one, make sure that your back is safe. So how big you go is really gonna depend on feeling like your core is engaged and it's nice and safe. But with this band, because it's so supportive, oftentimes you can get a nice big range of motion. And so I like to think about kind of playing with my end ring stretches. So when you go across, we kind of reach into that outer thigh stretch, and then you really press out and around, and then maybe take it out here to that place where it's a little stretch in those inner thighs, and then come back up. So as long as that's feeling okay on your back, and a lot of times that band gives you a bigger range than if you were just holding your leg up there in space, you can really get those nice fluid movements. And we inhale, maybe that first third of it, exhale to come around. Shoulders and head are anchored, but fine to get a little rotation through our hip there as you go across. And then let's go the other way. And we're shooting for about five. I wasn't really counting there, so we might not have been close to five, but somewhere in that range, right? Finding that breath and movement, just reaching into that strap so that we get those stretch moments. You get that, like, open your hip as that leg presses out. And of course, it still work, but it's kind of that feel-good work that our body kind of craves when we've been sitting and not getting to do those movements. Good. Maybe one more there. I'm going to make you count, Shelly. All right, let's go ahead and switch, and we'll do the other side. All right, so let's start off and just, yep. And Shelly's got this leg anchored. Just like on those stretches, you might need to bend this knee a little bit if those hamstrings are tight, but if it's fine to stretch it straight, you're going to stretch it straight and anchor the heel. She's going to reach across, get that nice outer thigh stretch, and then circle down and around. And just getting that sensation of kind of stirring your leg around in your hip, going through those different ranges where there's stretch right in that outer thigh and that inner thigh. And just that whole time, we're knitting our abdominals in. That's kind of our support system that whole time as we're coming around. Let's go that other way. And we'll do about five in each direction. And that standing leg, we're just kind of anchoring it down a little bit, pressing that heel in. Circling around. We're going to take two more there. And back up. Nice. And then as you come back around, you just kind of push your foot into that band and roll up to sitting. So as I come up, we're going to do a little roll in like a ball, one of my favorite exercises. We'll throw the TheraBand in. We're just going to double it up and hold the sides of it. Just kind of put our feet in there. And that roll in like a ball, make sure you have a nice cushion surface wherever you're doing this at. You're gonna lift your feet up, open the knees. I like this with the band because you kind of push your legs out into the band and kind of feel that little connection on there. And then you're gonna just roll. So inhaling to roll back, exhale to curl forward. And really with this sequence, like just thinking of that, like being able to roll through your back and kind of figuring out what you have to do it, right? Find to lift your legs a little bit. We just want to get that articulation and that rounding in our back that feels good, right? Giving ourselves that little massage, doing it with control. Big breath, running like a ball, really that breathing exercise as we inhale back and exhale forward. We'll just take a couple more there. Right. Kind of playful and fun. Feel good on our back. Again, make sure you have a nice cushioned surface that you're working on. Good. And then coming up from there. Charlie, let's just sit up tall. Let's head into, we're not going to use the theremin knees. We're going to do a little spine stretch and maybe a little saw. Haul in. So when you start off on this, you just want to get a nice tall spine. So Shelly's got her legs pretty straight, but if your hamstrings are tight, you might need to like really bend your knees to get that tall spine, and that is fine. Like go wherever that works for you. So she's sitting nice and tall. She's going to take a nice big inhale, and then as she exhales, she's curling down through her neck, her upper back, mid-back, low-back, stretching her spine. And then she comes back up and sequences up. Low-back, mid-back, upper back, and just lifts up through the crown of her head. And let's just take a few more there. And again, we just want that like bending through each little section of your spine so you feel that stretch and that length, probably feeling that stretch in those backs of the legs as well, which is awesome. Rolling up, lifting tall. Good. Let's do one more there. And on this one, just maybe hang out at the bottom a little bit. So we kind of get to that stretch place. I like to grab feet or toes, but you could play with it a little bit. You could pull your abdominals back as you're hanging on and just really get that stretch through your spine and through your legs. You might want to shimmy or shift or wiggle around a little bit. Just kind of a good place to get some of those stretch movements. Keep those core muscles engaged. Let the head and neck release. Can feel really good on there. And then as you're ready, we're going to just roll ourselves back up. Stack up nice and tall. Stretch those arms up to the side. And we're going to head into a little saw. So nice big inhale in our center. As you exhale, you're going to twist and then do that curl. And really press through the arms to open the shoulders and chest. Inhale, rolling up. And you get that little bit taller. Exhale into that twist and just pressing. So we get this nice, again, kind of stretch moments built in. Inhaling up. She's thinking about just keeping her hips anchored and rotating through that upper body. Inhaling as she stacks up. That breath really helps us. Helps us bring out that breath from our center. Every time, just kind of getting a little more. Let's take one more on each side. And again, these are all suggestions. If you're at home doing this, feel free to add a couple extras in. Kind of see what your body needs today. Up and then we're just going to relax those arms. I'm going to have you flip over to your belly. So we'll just turn right this way and either way. And we're going to do a little swan. So we're going to have hands underneath the shoulders and just take a moment. And we just flipped over. Maybe let your forehead rest on the mat. And you reach through the backs of the legs and just kind of that like wrapping your belly up and in and lengthening out your low back. And then we're going to do a little swan. So as you inhale, lifting your head, sternum, chest, rolling up through your spine. And then as you exhale, rolling down. And just like you could get a little longer as you come back down. And I don't know about anybody else, but when I've been traveling a lot or sitting a lot, my body kind of craves this like back bending. And I call it like the anti-computer sitting kind of movement. Right, so our shoulders get to roll open, our elbows reach back. And if it is there for you, you can leave your feet on the mat or you can lift your legs as you come up, which is going to give you a little more stretch to the fronts of the thighs and hips, a little more back of the leg work, and back down. Going to do like one more there. And that breath just helps us lengthen and lift. And then back down, nice. And then a little child's pose here. If child's pose feels good for you, you can shift back. And again, just kind of one of those good feel-good moments where you can really just let yourself hang out for a little bit. If you can find that place where your forehead can just be heavy on the mat, and then just kind of feel your hips reaching back, and just be there. Like taking that big breath and kind of just letting your spine lengthen out. A great place to be. If child's pose doesn't feel good for you, a nice alternative is to flip on your back and hug your legs in towards your knees. If this position doesn't feel good on those knees. And then as you're ready, we're going to come up, and we're going to end with our mermaid exercise, a little version of our mermaid exercise. So we're going to sit and just fold the legs to one side. So I'll push up, kind of tuck them. Yep. And what she'll do is arms out to the side a little bit. She's going to take an inhale. She's going to bring that hand kind of under her shoulder, and she's going to bend the elbow so that as she goes over, yeah, get to reach and lengthen. That's it. And then as you exhale, you're going to stack back up using those obliques, and then go the other way. And I like to kind of grab my ankle or shin a little bit and use it to help me get a little lift and reach over, and then stack back up. Good. And I might have you take that hand maybe a little further out. I know I said shoulder in the first time. So when you go, maybe you reach it a little further. Yep, so you have to reach and then bend that arm as you come down. Yeah, so we just get that nice length and stretch over. This is another, like, that side bending movement, one of those movements that for me, when I've been sitting a long time, I always think feels so good. And back, good. And then on this last one, we're going to just add, last one, we're going to add some little variation. So I'm going to have her go out and just stay out there. So she's in that nice side bend stretch, right? Supporting with this bottom arm. And then let's take this arm up to the ceiling. Shoulder all nice and connected, and then leaving her hips there, she's thinking rotate up toward the ceiling with her chest, and then kind of rotate toward the floor, go the other way. Yeah, and again, we're just getting some rotation and movement, using those core muscles. Of course, that bottom arm is having to work. Nice. Let's do one more there. And then just come out of it how you got there. So bring that top arm over your shoulder. Take a big breath. Reach through that top arm. And then we'll take one more stretch the other way. That up and over. Nice. And then stacking top. Beautiful. And then we're going to spin the other way. We'll just have Shelly flip her legs the other way. You can still face that same way if you want. Yep, that's perfect. And we're just going to do that on the other side to make sure you're even. So we'll just take that nice big inhale. Landing the hand. Bending, it kind of brings our elbow under our shoulder, and then we reach up and over. And then that stacking up, which really happens from those obliques, yeah, pulling us or engaging to come up. And then that feeling of lifting and side bending. Always we want to create length in our spine and kind of decompress everything. And that reaching out, just lengthening from that hip out. And then that coming up. And you can definitely use that bottom arm to help you, but kind of play with like using it only as much as you need so that those core muscles have to do the work to stack your spine back up. Good. And we're going to do that last one where we take the little rotation. So let Shelly kind of find her side bend, reaching out and over. And then we'll have her go, let's take like that arm straight up to the ceiling and then open it and kind of palm up to the ceiling, chest to the ceiling, and then rotate. Yeah, so we get this twist, which kind of feels amazing. One of my favorite ones on here. Big inhale. And then that exhale. Nice. We'll do one more there. Again, that bottom arm. Just stabilizing with that bottom shoulder. Watching that it doesn't scrunch up here. Nice. And then we'll take arm up to the ceiling. And you get to stack up just how you got there. Come up. One last little counter stretch. Up and over that other direction. Nice big breath. And then coming back. Ta-da! And that's it. That's our little summer travel workout. Hopefully you enjoy it. Hopefully it feels good. Gives you some ideas of some things you can do when you are traveling or really anywhere. You don't even have to be traveling to do that. So hope you're having a great summer. You can always get some more information about the studio online at www.rivercitypilates.com.